Sujanarbudaraditopadajugam jugadhar madhurandharo patruvaram varadabhayadayokapuyapadam pranamami sada prabhupadupadam pranamami sada prabhupadupadam pranamami sada prabhupadupadam. Gaudiya Goshipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that without 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, you cannot speak about that absolute truth, absolute way. Gaudiya Goshipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, without submission, 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you cannot speak about that absolute truth, absolute way. To speak anything about the absolute truth, to speak anything about that absolute truth, you will have to go up to that absolute level. To speak anything about that absolute truth, you will have to go up to that absolute level, otherwise you cannot speak absolute truth, about that absolute truth. Actually, if you are going to compromise with some sahajiya, or maybe you want to make some compromise with your pratishtha, you like to get some material pratishtha, in that case, you can go for compromise with some other party, those who are not following Prabhupada 100%. Compromise means you will have to leave some good and accept some bad from the opponent party. Compromise 100% means, what do you mean compromise? Compromise 100%, compromise means you will have to accept some bad thing from the opponent party, leave some good thing. Otherwise, compromise cannot be done. Actually, only and only this single Acharya, Prabhupad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad, speaking repeatedly that in pure devotional field, in pure devotional field, you cannot go for compromise. In pure devotional field, there is no way other than following our Guru Varga intact, toto. If you are going to follow our Guru Varga, Gauriya Bhaktivinoda Dara, then you can never go for compromise. Compromise means you will have to accept this, that is the main problem. In whole life, Srila Prabhupada never go for compromise with those sahajiyas. In whole life, Prabhupada never go for compromise with anybody regarding pure devotional matter. Not only that, but also Prabhupada used to speak that way, that Prabhupada used to speak this way, that I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada used to speak that I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. Only without except Radharani and those Sakhis, except Radharani, this speech is impossible. This speech, you see, what Prabhupada is speaking, nobody can understand. Somebody can think Prabhupada has some fighting mood. Not that. Prabhupada speaking, I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani, actual preaching of Krishna. What do you mean? That means actually Radharani cannot compromise regarding Seva of Shamsundar. If there is any defect in you, she cannot allow. Because Radharani always, she always want to seek that 100% satisfaction of Krishna. 100% satisfaction of Krishna. She always want to find 100% satisfaction of Krishna. That's why she cannot compromise. That's why Guru Varga suggest, better you can come and take shelter in Gaurdham. Because though Gauranga Mahaprabhu Radharani is there, but still, it is the standing commitment of Nityananda or Gauranga Mahaprabhu that they are going to excuse you anyway. Repeatedly you are making some mistake regarding Seva. But one thing, you should not do any Vaishnava aparad. Any Seva aparad, this, that you are doing, that can be excused. But Vaishnava aparad can never be excused. Nama aparad, somehow you can get excused by the mercy of Nam. Dhamma aparad, you can get excused by the mercy of Dhamma. Nityananda Tatta, Baladev Tatta. But you can never get excused if you are going to commit Vaishnava aparad. I mean, unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava aparad, if you are doing, then in the no excuse you cannot, you can get. Actually, Guru Seva and Guru Bhog, not same. To enjoy Guru, to enjoy Gurudev, Gurudev name, fame and position, to enjoy the name, fame and position of Gurudev. To enjoy the name, fame of Gurudev and to serve Gurudev, not same. To serve Gurudev and to take Seva, to serve Gurudev and to take Seva from Gurudev, all not same. All not same. Sometimes we are very clever. We are so clever, we want to expose, we want to show people that we are doing all Guru Seva so nicely. You see, I am the main sevak of Gurudev. But anyway, you cannot make fool of Gurudev. Sadguru is so clever, because he has direct connection with Krishna. You cannot make fool of Gurudev. Gurudev knowing who want to get what thing from me. That's why Siddhanti Maharaj, a disciple of Prabhupada, used to speak very heavily. In his last message, wanted to speak, who is actual sevak? Who is actual sevak? Who is actual Guru sevak? And who is not? Who is actual Guru sevak? And who is actually not? You can detect after Gurudev pass away from this material world. You can watch the activities of those people. Then you can readily arrest them. They are in line with Gurudev or not. They are doing all nonsense, which never Gurudev approved. Never Prabhupada approved. They want to speak Gurudev. Any Siddhanta Virod they are speaking, always speaking, my Gurudev told it. Any speaking rubbish, anything. People looking, what? My Gurudev told it. Want to get support. But actual genuine sevak, guru sevak, never want to do like that. To serve Gurudev and to take service from Gurudev, not same. Totally, totally difference. So, for name, fame and position, I can take help of the reputation my Guru Maharaj already have in this material world. Sometimes some famous Vaishnava going away from this material world, I want to search some letter, this, that, to prove that he, I was very near and dear unto the devotee. I want to search some letter, this, that, and expose. You see, he used to write me. I am very near and dear unto that devotee, that, you know, acharya. So naturally he is going to get the favor of their follower. Those who are going to follow that acharya, they automatically want to, the flow always coming this way. But pure Vaishnava, they don't care what pratishtha you are giving or not, they spit on pratishtha. If you are not going to spit on pratishtha, then be sure, you can never become a pure Vaishnava. Maybe whole world going to worship you, this, that, what it concerned to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This matters little. So anyway, to serve Gurudev and to take service from Gurudev are not the same. In the whole life of Prabhupada, we have seen never wanted to take pratishtha, nothing. On the contrary, he used to say, I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. For the emancipation of these conditioned souls, I can come down to any level. Maybe those people can criticize, Gurudev speaking this way, Gurudev is doing this way, this should not be done. Even those who took shelter unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, some of them, they all started criticizing Gurudev. Why is Gurudev doing this way? They cannot understand the mood of Prabhupada. When Hanumanji Maharaj, you can remember, he is also Acharya. Hanumanji Maharaj, as now we can speak, that he is Murari Gupta. Eh? But Hanumanji Maharaj, when he was so mighty man, powerful, Ravan actually set fire to his leg. Tail. Tail is burning. Hanuman said, this is the opportunity. I can jump here and there and set fire whole Lanka. Whole Lanka was set fire. Whole Lanka burning. Thousands of people, they are dying there. Men, women, children, everything. Then one question was put in front of Hanumanji Maharaj. Hanumanji Maharaj, you are actually Vaishnava. Very topmost Vaishnava. How you kill all those Lanka, you are committing this kind of, you know, papa you are doing. Well, no, I have done no papa. I have done no aparad, no pap. Then, you already set fire whole Lanka. So what? I have done Ram Seva. I have done exact Seva unto the lotus feet of Ramchandra. I have done Seva, 100% Seva unto the lotus feet of Ramchandra. I have no vanity here. I have done no mistake, no offense, no crime, nothing. So you see, those Gopikas, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna, you know, going to prove that I am sick, my headache, big headache, no doctor can check up and find out the actual reason for why Krishna is so sick, headache. Now what medicine? All doctor, Ayurvedic doctor coming for treatment, they are all failure. Now, Krishna Bhagavan is going to speak the medicine. You can go to Vrindavan and Brajadam and get the dust powder from the lotus feet of the Brajavasis, especially Gopikas. So, Naradji running here and there to collect, nobody ready to give. You mad? We can give dust powder from lotus feet? Foolish? They're gone. Naradji. But when Naradji is going to reach Brajadham, those, you know, Brajagopikas, they say, how much dust particle you need, you can take. We are ready to give to Krishna. We are ready to go to hell. Prabhupada speaking, to serve Paramahansa Guru, Srila Gaurakishadas Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Guru. I am so, you know, I have so much vanity that with contact, I am ready to go to hell. with due contact, I like to go to hell. I am so, you know, vanity, with my fist of fury, I can drive away all the evils there in their head. That much vanity I have. To serve my Paramahansa Gurudev, what I can do? I can go to hell for infinity reward with due contact. This should be the mood of Sadguru, a Satsisya. Satsisya means Sadguru. It's like mathematics. If you learn mathematics formula, you can understand. Sadguru means Satsisya. Surely he was Satsisya. That's why Sadguru. It's the formula, secret formula. If you find in this material world one Satsisya who is ready to sacrifice his own life for the cause of Guru Gauranga and Gurudev, he is ready, 100%, any time. Not that you can point out those, you know, freedom fighter, they are ready to, I can give my life from my motherland. They are ready to give their life from motherland. But we are not ready to give our life. What to speak about? Money, position, time, nothing we are ready to give absolutely from our heart to Gurudev. We are liar actually. So one freedom fighter is ready to give life for motherland, though it's not 100% spiritual, some spiritual touch must be there. Yes. But here you see, at the time of Diksha, we are bound to, you know, make a commitment. Diksha kale, shishya kare, atma samarpan. The submission, without a submission, Diksha, the kind of Diksha you are getting is not perfect Diksha. That's why different kind of confusion, you know, growing inside heart, so much people, they are misled. They are right, hearing these, that, Siddhanta, they cannot understand, they are in confusion. Whom to follow, how to follow, what Siddhanta is perfect, this big problem. They are growing confusion day by day. That's why they can go to hell very easily. Because Sansayatma Vinashvati. Very dangerous situation at present. That day I was speaking, na? Some devotee crying, na, in Radha, in Sam Kunda, at the band of Sam Kunda, I was doing parikram. He is crying and say, I am sure, Maharaj, in the bank of Sam Kunda, Maharaj, I am sure that you can save me. You can save me. He was very disappointed because he can understand, he can feel by now the situation of his material guru. Understand. He is crying, I don't speak at the time of parikram usually, if devotee there, then speaking some harikatha. Then I was bound to speak this way because otherwise he is crying. I say, man, you see, if you are 100% sure, if you are 100% sure that I can save you, if you are 100% sure that I can save you, then be sure that you are saved. At present, big problem. I can give you one example, then you can understand. Barishal, one place at present in Bangladesh. That's why I know Bangladesh, now separate country, but that time is undivided India. Barishal, one place. From there, one Chief Justice. In relation to the Chief Justice, his brother and nephew actually, nephew. His name is Rohini Babu. Rohini Babu from childhood very much, you know, impressed to start actual bhakti, but who can, like Tapan Mishra, I already told you, when Mahaprabhu going in the name of teaching Vyakaran in Bangladesh, Mahaprabhu went, not that. Actually, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak about Sambandha Vidya Prayajan, very massive teaching. That time one nice Brahman elevated, he cannot understand how to do bhajan. Still today is the ambiguity there. Very big complicacy. Sambandha vidya prajan. How to do bhajan? Sambandha should, you should grow sambandha by the mercy of your powerful guru. If you are not at all going to grow sambandha again as yet, then how you can expect you can start bhajan? How? So guru, sadguru can show you your sambandha with Gurudev. Not so. Can discover and show you, see, you have your eternal relation with Bhagavan. Foolish. You are going to waste your time. You have no relation. You have no relation with this material world. Foolish number one. You have no relation with this material world. No money, no property, no husband, no wife, no daughter, no son, nobody. You have only relation, eternal relation with Krishna. But you are so foolish, you are going to cut relation with Krishna. You want to make relation with material people and material object to put you into the ocean of misery. That is the main point. Mahaprabhu went there not for Vyakaran teaching. Secret reason is there. Mahaprabhu wanted to preach sambandha vidya prajan, actual devotional. Now Tapan Mishra for a long time, by that time, was very, you know, anxious to know actual guidance, to get actual guidance. How to do bhajan? Where I can get proper guidance? Then the night time, he go in dream, he find one order. Hey! Nimai coming, the great Pandit. He is actually, he can solve your problem. You can go. Then in the morning time, he coming and takes shelter. Prabhu can take. Then Prabhu giving him sambandha vidya prajan. These three. Guru Padpadma used to speak this way. Kalikale sadhupava kothin janiya. It is from Jagadananda Pandit's writing. Guru Padpadma used to speak this very often. Kalikale sadhupava kothin janiya. Sadhu Guru Rupe Krishna Aila Nodiya. Bengali, you are learning Bengali, huh? By now you are not understanding this sloka also. Foolish. So many teachers, so many things, and brain is one. All garbage. So you see, Guru Padma used to speak, Sadhu Guru Rupe Krishna, Sadhu is very rare in this Kalikal. In this Kalikal is very rare to get actual sadhu, dedicated soul. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Krishna, that's why Krishna came in the form of sadhu. Follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way we'll have to do bhajan, this way we'll have to do is the swaying all the time. Hey, that is the reason for why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, to show us sambandha vidya prajan, everything. And the ultimate goal, prajan means prajan tattva also, topmost prajan tattva. Prajan tattva in four sampradaya, different sampradaya can be their different kind of prajan tattva. But this prajan tattva in Gaudiya society, especially in Gaudiya Math, why I speak this way? Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada there. Prajan tattva, you can get topmost prajan, the scientific prajan tattva there. So, the way, and this, you know, Tapan Mishra going to get guidance, everything. Similarly, you see, this, you know, Rohini Babu, he want to get proper guidance, what to do. He running here and there. He is running here and there, like mad. Now coming to Navadvip, taking bath in Ganga, but somehow due to bad luck, he was going to get, he was bound to get the association of Pesahajiya, Baul Guru. Baul Guru, you know? Baul Guru, Sahajiya. A Gurudeva's wife also there. They take this disciple there. Okay, you come, we can guide you properly. You can stay with us. Take meat and fish, everything, no problem. You will have to get some power. Otherwise, how we can get? Those are ex-mission, Y-mission say, hey, you must get some power. If you are not going to take meat and fish, how we can get power? They are so idiot speaking this way. Actually, nayam atma balahina na labhya. Nayam atma, nayam atma balahina na labhya. This word is for chitbal. For chitbal. They want to prove this way. So anyway, Rohini Babu somehow got some opportunity to cross the river and come to, you know, here and there moving. And discover that Prabhupada speaking Harikatha. Somehow. He stand and looking at the power of Prabhupada, you know, like effulgence coming. Great effulgence coming from the body of Prabhupada, so glamorous, so powerful. He hear Harikatha minutely. Some he couldn't understand. This Harikatha is very transcendental of Prakita. After that Harikatha is over, paying Dandavat and gone to his Gurudev room. House, Sahajiya, Baul Guru, and somehow took something night time, taking rest, and in dream he is, you know, going to see one strange thing. The Baul Guru is tiger, and and the wife of Baul Gurudev is tigress, sea tiger. And he tiger. They are from both sides, they are going to attack Rohini Babu in dream and eat up. Then he break his dream and get up and sweating. Oh, what I see? In the meantime, when right opportunity got, he fly from that place. And come and straightway, you know, submit unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Follow, you see, he got diksha, everything from there. Very nice, actually. This way, at present, thousands of people, they are being cheated. They are not getting actual information. That is the main problem. With us. Main problem. So you see, say in whole life, Prabhupada never going for any compromise with anybody. Exceptional personality. Exceptional acharyaship. I was bound to speak that way loudly. That with the manifestation of the exclusive acharyaship of Prabhupada, with the exclusive acharyaship of Prabhupada, with the manifestation of the exclusive acharyaship of Prabhupada, all other common acharyaship was proved to be fraud, false. All other common acharyaship were proved to be false, all false. This is the unique acharyaship of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada was bound to speak that in my devotional life, I was running from Kanna Kumarika up to Himalaya end. But I am sorry to speak that I cannot find such jivatma, those who can digest this kind of exclusive harikatha, siddhanta, unalloyed truth. Because I know you are going to speak truth, but you are foolish. Half truth is not truth. You are going to speak about truth. I am sure that you are speaking about truth. You can chase me. I am speaking truth, but I can prove that you are speaking half truth. You are speaking half truth, not full truth, 100%. Half truth is equal to false. Half truth is not truth. So, those who are not in a position to speak or accept this apparent truth, how we can expect they can accept their absolute truth? Follow my point. Those who are not in a position to accept this apparent truth, how we can expect that they can accept absolute truth? They are speaking all the time lie. False, very small thing. Very small, for library, these, that, they are all speaking lie. False. They want to cheat me, but they cannot cheat me. They wanted to cheat me. I have so many letters I can show you. Solo. Say false, simple thing. For they are not in a position to speak about that absolute truth. Whereas they are not in a position to speak about that material truth. Yes or no? Yes or no, they're speaking no. Lie. Even apparent truth they cannot accept. How we can expect that they can accept that absolute truth? Is it possible for them? That's why actually Baba speaking, whole life I am running here and there, but I cannot find such jivatma, those who can digest the absolute truth, except our Guru Bhargava, because our Guru Bhargava is eternal person. In this context, I must be that there's some sahajiya speaking always, that all those going to take Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada, they are all eternal persons of Prabhupada. They're speaking this way. Because they have some relation, grandfather or grandmother, maybe uncle that took Diksha from Prabhupada. Hey, it's eternal persons. But where from you get this Siddhanta? Where from you can get this Siddhanta that all they took Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada, that all eternal persons of Prabhupada, who told you this Siddhanta? We are proud that the total, you know, Siddhanta, total, you know, efficacy of Prabhupada, total, everything. Parampuja Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj could realize. Total. Prabhupada, with all his Siddhanta, Vichar, efficacy, I mean total, Sarup of Prabhupada was reflected totally inside the heart of Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Otherwise, how it is possible to write? Kipaya Hari Ketana Murti Dharam Dharani Varaharaka Gaura Janam Janakadika Vasala Snigda Padam Panamami Sada Prabhupada Padam. If you go through the Dadasakam, Prabhupada, then I can show you all the sarupa Prabhupada, everything. I mean the last line stanza, Vishobhanushutadaitanucharam. What do you mean? Prabhupada also not directly speaking that I am Noyanmani Manjuri. Those are our Guru Varga, they are very clever. Sometime Prabhupada wrote one letter to some devotee that Vrishvanu Nandini always want to protect that foolish, you know, this Gopabalika, but like eyeball. Radharani want to give full protection to this foolish Gopabalika, like eyeball, eyelid always protecting this eyeball. But that foolish, you know, Gopabalika always like to run here and get some scope here and there. This way Prabhupada speaking, indication. Like Radharani want to protect this money, eyeball. That's why Nayanmani Manjari. Vishobhanu sutadaitanu charam charanastrita. You know? So this way, Prabhupada is going to give indication, full indication, that she has eternal relation, he has eternal relation with Radharani this way. So you see, those who want to make this kind of Siddhanta, that all those who took Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada, they are eternal parts of Prabhupada. This Siddhanta is not proper Siddhanta. Because Srila Siddhar, by the mercy of Siddhar Goswami, we can know that Prabhupada took sannyas base. Potito dharanekkita vesha jithim. Prabhupada took sannyas base to travel and here and there to protect all bonded souls. But if I can speak this way, all those who took Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada, they are all eternal Prasad, this Siddhanta is not good. Because in that case, you want to speak Prabhupada coming with all Parikar Vaishishta and going away with full troops, Parikar and Vaishishta. No new man, no new Jivatma was delivered. It's not Siddhanta. Oh. Patito dharanekkita vesha jitim jyotiraj ganai parisebva padam. This slok can prove. So this way you see, we can prove that those who then now question is that you are speaking in such a mood that we can feel some pain, but no question of pain. Now you can put question in front of me that then what is your Siddhanta? Not my Siddhanta. It's Siddhanta Prabhupada. I can prove. Those who coming to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to serve, they are not all Parikar. They are not eternal Parsad all. Some new devotees also, new people, new Jivatma also. Follow? Now Prabhupada giving Siddhanta, then who all? Whom you can speak that they are eternal Parsad? Eternal Parsad means they are going to establish all the Siddhanta Vichara of Srila Prabhupada. Namam Vishnu Padayo Krishna Pishtaya Bhutale Simate or Gaura Pishtaya Bhutale. Gaura Prasthaya Bhutale. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to implement? All Rup Sanatan, Jiva Goswami Pad Sanatan, all coming to implement the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Similar way, same Siddhanta. Those who wanted to implement the Siddhanta Vichara of Srila Prabhupada in toto in their life, in toto, they don't care how much pratishtha you want to. One or two examples I can give, it is more than sufficient. Kuresh was ready to give whole life for Gurudev. Be careful. One example is more than sufficient. Try to apply your devotional mood to understand, actual devotional mood. Otherwise you cannot find any solution. Kuresh was 100% ready to give it his whole life for Gurudev. Who there? Ready? Like we have seen Keshav Goswami, I can discuss the day of Keshav Goswami appearance or disappearance day. Who ready to give life for Prabhupada? Siddhanti Maharaj speaking in whole thousands of people there. Thousands of people there. Siddhanti Maharaj, Siddha Sarup, I think his name was, speaking loudly. X mission, Y mission, they are actually hooligan, Dhormiyo Gunda. And they are all foolish. They are spiritual hooligan, spiritual mafia. Those spiritual mafia, they like to dominate the whole spiritual world. But if you can search the reality, all vacant. They are all spiritual mafia. Siddhanta Maharaj speaking loudly. That foolish, you know, spiritual leader who went to outside country, here American, here there, got huge name and clapping. But actually, is foolish. His Gurudev is also foolish pujari. Foolish pujari. Nothing else. Big agitation started. Why you speak this way? You know? So much power they speak. Information came to Bobad. Siddhartha was speaking in whole open sava, speaking this way. Thousands of people, they agitated. Prabhupada speaking, at least he is having that kind of power to speak about that absolute way. Prabhupada is very happy. At least I can find one, you know, devotee who is speaking this way, absolute to the absolute way. Point out, see, you are doing all false. You are misguiding whole society. What is your position? How you can guide them? At least I find one. Very nice. Siddha Sabru at least speaking this way. Almost fighting going on. Then Siddhar Goswami Maharaj is very clever. Take control of the situation. Also. And that time when our Kesava Goswami was speaking, that was also very dangerous. So this way actually, Prabhupada, Saradendu Bandopadhyaya or Sai, forget Saradendu Babu. One question and answer going on, he is putting question in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you are actually so, you know, lucky, you see, within this short period of time, you are making at least, you know, by that time it was 34 or 36, I forget. Temple you are making 64 or less, some, or more, 66. We know 64. After that I get information, more than 64. Saradendu Bandopadhyaya, when putting question, maybe that time 64. After that, you are making so much more. Prabhupada speaking, come on. What do you speak? 64 Gaudiya Math? What do you mean? I wanted to install Gaudiya Math inside the heart of all Jivatma. 64. Huh. I want to install Gaudiya Math inside the heart of everybody. 64 Gaudiya Math. In place of 64 Gaudiya Math, in place of 64 Gaudiya Math, if I can get 64 living Gaudiya Math, who can speak all about this absolute truth, absolute way, about the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Bani, absolute way, then I am very happy. In place of 64 Gaudiya Maths, if I can get 64 living Gaudiya Math, living Midanga, those are running here and there, with their character, with their behavior, with their Siddhanta, Acharan, they are in a position to inculcate the Siddhanta Bichar in the inside heart of those bonded souls. They again give some impression into the heart of those bonded souls. I'm unlucky. I cannot get. Now at present, we are speaking to run Gaudiya Math. Guru Padma used to speak, I heard from Guru Bharga, to run Gaudiya Math, you must follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I heard from Srila Bhakti Purigoshana Paramahansa Sastra. He used to speak this way. I am in Vyasasan. If you like to run Gaudiya Math, you will have to follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur in toto. Otherwise, you cannot run Gaudiya Math. Gaudiya Math can only be driven by the power of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, not by your willpower. Whatever fanciful Siddhanta you can put and do whatever you like, nonsense. This way Guru Padman used to speak, right? So you see, Gaudiya Math can only be run by the mercy of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, not by your. This way, you see, all our Guru Bhargava wanted to install the Siddhanta Bichar of Srila Prabhupada. They said they are Guru Bhargava. They are actually eternal parshad of Srila Prabhupada. They are actually eternal parshad of Srila Prabhupada. Not all, everybody not parshad. Those who wanted to implement directly the Siddhanta Bichar of Prabhupada, they don't fear. That's why I started with this point. If you are not 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Guru, Vaishnava, and Bhagavan, you cannot speak about their spirit truth. You can always go for this account, how much profit I can get, profit and loss account. This way if I speak, I can get this kind of profit. If I can speak this way, I am going to lose. So you are busy with, you know, profit and loss account, so you are businessman. As per Prabhupada, you are businessman, you are always thinking of profit and loss account. You are thinking about profits and loss. Profit and loss account. Prabhupada. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Prahlad Maharaj was speaking. He is not devotee. So boy bonika. Boy means nishchita meva. Be sure he is businessman. He is always thinking about this action I am going to take. So this way I can lose this my position and rank. Maharaj, if Bharati Maharaj is there with me at present, then he could speak in front of you the absolute truth. They are shouting in front of Bharati Maharaj, okay, you can write, nobody can touch you. But nobody is speaking like Bharati Maharaj. So I love Bharati Maharaj. Bharati Maharaj speaking, yes! All Guru Vaishnava giving you order to write this way, you can write this way. Nobody can touch you. Prabhu is there to protect you. But all other, they give me inspiration. Oh, Maharaj, very nice writing. Oh, very good. After that, when I print books and distribute, if I put the book in their mat, they're giving order to the computer man, put this book inside, go down, don't distribute, idiot. I say, why? Is books here? But your acharya speak me to keep this book here, not to distribute. Oh my God, how cheater there? How liar there? How cheater? One day, big acharya. I was bound to inform him, not directly, indirectly. This is a position, this, you know, society, big society, they wanted to insult our Guru Bhargava this way, writing this, that in their books. Directly, indirectly, but through proper channel. I was waiting for the answer. What answer giving that acharya? He is speaking, at all there is any such Siddhanta, we can check up, no problem. I said, come on, for 45 years, the Siddhanta is there in their book. You want to make fool of me? He never gone through this Siddhanta? 100% knowing. He is going to give answer, then he is going to lose his own position, material pratishtha. He is speaking in front of me. Oh, at all, Maharaj Babaji Maharaj speaking about, if at all there is any such Siddhanta, we can check up, we can give answer. All gone, everything gone. Now, 12 years, 15 years gone. Now they are not going to answer. Because if they answer, they are going to lose their own position. So how we can expect that they are 100% inclined unto lotus feet? Any Siddhanta they can speak. You can buy books from market and recite and speak in front of me. You have your right. Only Bharati Maharaj told, in Vyasasana speaking, you all go through these books, you can know so many information you can get in open sava, in Puri, Prabhupada place, only Bharati Maharaj. Nobody speaking. I wanted to put their name. I am junior, actually. I like to, no, don't, it's right. You can publish. But they are not ready to include their name in that book. They don't want to get involved in problem. If at all anybody like to kill me, okay, Sambhava, no disciple, no temple, there will be. Who is going to cry for Sambhava? How can all problem can count on me? But one, why I have so much, you know, belief, where Prabhupada speaking, I can show you. Prabhupada speaking, that's why I have this, that much, you know, faith. Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to speak absolute way about that absolute truth, if the whole world going to attack you, nobody can do any harm to you, because that absolute truth for whom you are dedicated, that absolute truth can come down to protect you 100%. I believe this. I don't believe you and everybody. But I know they believe on money power. They believe on manpower. But I have no manpower, no money power. I only believe Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhavan Puri Goswami, I know they are not cheater. 100% they are genuine. So I believe on them. So Kures 100% ready to give their life. Kures. But not everybody. Keshav Goswami Maharaj ready to give life. Okay, let them kill me. I like to protect my Gurudev. Gurudev is already protected. My Supreme Lord. But still was one kind of chance to serve Gurudev that way. So this way actually, nobody liked at present specially. At present specially, if you discuss about Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur absolute way, everybody says, don't go there. You can lose your bhakti. They can speak this way. But you see the life of Prabhupada. When Prabhupada was invited there, where? Raja Manindraji Murshidabad, local 10. Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda used to travel a local 10. Now any cheap devotee like me can get some facility. But they used to travel by local 10. Local 10 simply. Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhavan, they used to travel by local 10. I like to suffer. I like to suffer. Don't give enjoyment. Don't give me any facility. I like to suffer so that I can grow that kind of tolerance, so that you can throw me in jungle of Vrindavan, so that I can tolerate. I've been there. Not that I'm speaking. Very happy. Nobody. But by the order of Prabhupada, I cannot seek my personal happiness, Prabhupada speaking. Prabhupada speaking, those in the form of devotee speaking, oh, he is very tranquil, very peaceful devotee. He don't like to go into any kind of confrontation with anybody. He likes to lead his peaceful life. Prabhupada is foolish. He has some passive karma. You want to give garland to prove that he is great devotee? Prabhupada speaking, no, foolish you are. He is not great devotee. He want to get, you know, peaceful life, lead peaceful life, Prabhupada speaking. Surely he has some passive calm, not direct calm. He is having passive calm. I like to live my life peacefully? What do you mean? Tumar shevai dukho hai yato seho to param sukh. For your seva, if the whole world is going to attract me, I am in the misery, I am in trouble. It is also I can give salute. Okay, Prabhu. For your seva, everybody likes to attract me, put me in trouble. So many allegations, they want to put proof. So what? Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Tomar sevai dukho hai yato seho to param sukh. Are Mara, how I can cook? I have no time, I have that seva, Vaishnava speaking me to. You will have to manage. That day I told you. That day I was bound to speak that way. Srila Bhakti Pradeep Tirtha Maharaj. Because you all are so lazy, Maharaj speaking. So lazy, right from the 2:30 in the morning. 2:30 we are, you know, like candle. Candle, if you set fire, candle giving light to everybody. But candle himself going to burn up, and you know. That's why devotee giving light to everybody never try to seek his own interest. Bhakti Pradeep Tirtha Maharaj says, right from the 2:30 we have no time, always seva, always seva. Then I offer bhoga, everything, arsha, everything. After that, I give prasadam to Prabhupada. There is no permanent temple, temporary temple there. And I'm trying to Navadip to sell Nadia Prakash. Then by 3 o'clock, 3:30, I come back and take bath. Again, open temple, doing kirtan, writing. Oh my God. Now you can say, Maharaj, how we can get time? This question we can put because we are not 100% dedicated. Really, we are not 100% dedicated. In material life, I can show example that material love up to the extreme limit, up to the extreme limit of material level, up to the extreme limit of material level, love, Laila Majnu, Nal Damanti, Jim Della, their love is up to the extreme point. Extreme point mean within this material level. But still Prabhupada said it is not approved. What to speak about aprakita love? What to speak about transcendental love? Transcendental bliss. So this way actually Prabhupada is speaking. When Prabhupada was invited, you know that answer I speak, they want to seek their own happiness. They want to seek their own peaceful, you know, they want to lead their life peacefully. There is also karma, passive karma, not direct karma. Passive karma is totally prohibited. Passive karma is totally prohibited because if direct karma is there, still I have the chance to give some treatment to you. Our Guru Varga can give treatment. But if passive karma, you want to prove that you are devotee, you want to cheat me, that karma is there inside heart. You are not going to expose in front of public to prove that you are a great devotee. That is more and more dangerous. Mithya charo sauchate in Gita. Mithya charo sauchate, you want. Mithya char mean? You are a liar, cheater. Mithya char sauchate. So we never find this kind of thing with our Keshav Goswami Mahabhakti Mahapuridya Antare Bahire Sama Babahar. When Prabhupada was invited by Raja Manindra Chanda, he was a plain-hearted man. Raja Manindra Chanda was not bad man, Prabhupada told. Somehow Raja Manindra Chanda was very nice man. Man, as a man he was very good, but not devotee. As a man he was good, favorable. He used to love Guru Vaishnava. He said, okay, no. But he is guided by some idiot peoples. His group all cheater, Prabhupada told. His group. He is staying with the groups, full troops are all cheater. So how I can protect them? Raja Manindra invite Prabhupada, Prabhupada going there. 5 days Dharma Shabha, 5 days open Dharma Sambelan. Open discourse on Bhagavatam. Hey, Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma. But they don't allow Prabhupada to speak even 5 minutes. They don't allow even Prabhupada to speak 5 minutes. Stop it! Stop it! We don't like to speak. You are not Vaishnava. You are speaking this way. You have no etiquette. Prabhupada stop Harikatha there. Prabhupada stop for 5 days, not for 3 days. Prabhupada not speaking, taking not even water. So Prabhupada giving us teachings. If you are going for preaching, of course, if you have that kind of quality. Without quality, no question coming. Why you are going to a preaching? Why you are making garbage? Huh? You are giving service to your, you know, disciple. That kind of situation. So if you are not elevated up to that level, so don't go for preaching. Guru Padmanabha used to say, what preaching? Do bhajan fast. What you can distribute? If you have no power, what you can distribute? Falsity? You can take shelter of falsity? So Prabhupada wanted to teach us this way. If somebody is not going to accept anything from you, you have no right to take anything from him. Just few days before, only 12 or 15, I just reached from Vrindavan. Next day I go to Calcutta. Calcutta Devananda Gaudiya Math, from there one devotee of ISKCON, he respects me very much, he hears Harikatha. He requests me, Maharaj, for 5 minutes you have to go to our house. My father and mother, very sorry, you have to come. We have Madan Mohan, your house, they established Madan Mohan by devotees, Gaudiya devotees. I was bound to go not alone with some devotee also. I go there and speak something, not Harikatha actually. They are crying and putting this kind of, you know, thing. So I was bound to answer that way, paid Andavar to Madan Mohan for 5, not more than 10 minutes. And when I come back, they wanted to give one, you know, big plate, decorated plate, with different kind of, you know, things, fruits and this, that, one full patra. I say, why you are giving? I cannot give anything to you. Maharaj, you are not going to take money. I know if I take money, they are not going to take anything. If at all they are going to take anything, then in future I can take. So I can take you to my goshala, that plate is still there. I told him, don't use it for bhog. You keep this plate there. If I find that they are not going to accept anything from me, I can take the plate and give them back. That plate is there. It is still kept, 15 days. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, if somebody is not going to accept anything from you, follow, then I am also not going to take anything. That's why Prabhupada was not ready to take even a drop of water for 3 days, consecutive days. When Prabhupada came back here in Mayapur, then took water. This way, no compromise. One day, from there, Navadvip, Sahaja, so many people, they are requesting Prabhupada, Vimala Prasad. Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj, there. Actually, we request you to come and speak some Harikatha. We heard that you are a great Pandit, great scholar. We like to hear some Harikatha from you. Prabhupada said, come on, okay. If at all I am not going that side of river for their sahaja, but okay. If they are at all interested to hear some Harikatha, Gaudiya Siddhanta, okay, I can go. They arrange one Harikatha in one place, Vimalapasa Saraswati, going there in the evening time, like fire, sitting in Vyasasana, speaking Harikatha, Bandana, and speaking Harikatha like fire. Nobody can digest. Suddenly, when speaking, my Guru Padmapada Paramahansa Sestra, he never care for any pratishtha, his speech on pratishtha. My Paramahansa Guru Padmapada was so elevated. In the meantime, when open the eyes, a fine Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj sitting in the audience and hearing Harikatha from Guru. Oh my God! When open eyes, find Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj Paramahansa Gurudev sitting in the audience, hearing Harikatha. When Prabhupada is going to speak something, some topics about Gaurkishore Baba, he get up and go away from this place. Now he is going to glorify me. So, oh my God. Prabhupada stunned. My Guru Pad Padma, he is sitting in audience to hear Harikatha from me. Oh my God. This is the example. This is the example why you love Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj so much. Why you so much, so many Paramahansa there. So many Paramahansa Acharya there. Paramahansa Gurudev. Those who are acting as Acharya, except that, so many Paramahansa there. They are doing bhajan, leave their body. Oh, why we are so much, you know, grateful to Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj? Because through his character, etiquette, and speech, always wanted to give warning to us, because we are cheater. We are cheater. For only Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj speaking this way. Nobody else. Even Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj was so, you know, powerful. One day speaking very heavily to Vimala Prasad. Sadguru Dev, Paramahansa, always thinking, you all, my Guru Varga, I have something to learn from you. I have something to learn from him. I have something to learn from my twin mother. Always I think, I have something to learn. Always you will have to think that way. Otherwise you think, I am guru. You can have that kind of contamination inside your heart. Ami to Vaishnav, ebuddhi hoile, amani nahavamani. You learn this kirtan, not doing this kirtan. Why not doing? We have very short life. Why you are giving time, this and that? You are not doing kirtan. Ami to Vaishnav, ebuddhi hoile, amani nahavamani. If I think I am great Vaishnav, then never I can become humble, humbler than the blade of grass. I can think you all my disciple. And if my Guru Maharaj is giving right teachings to me, I can think all you my Guru Bharga. So go about by this behavior, Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj wanted to prove that Bimala Prasad is not my disciple. Always Babaji Maharaj used to speak, Amar Prabhu, Amar Prabhu. Bimala Prasad, Amar Prabhu. Prabhu means Guru. Gaur Kishor Baba always used to speak this way. Amar Prabhu, you have come here. Oh, my Prabhu, you have come here. One day Gaur Kishor Baba was speaking heavily. Amar Prabhu, be careful. That devotee always approaching you to request you to get some lesson from Chaitanya Bhagavat. Don't give any lesson to him. Be careful, my Prabhu, Amar Prabhu. Bimala Prasad hearing. What happens, Babaji Maharaj? Actually, he is teacher. He actually cheater. Not teacher. Teacher. Cheater, actually. He is always putting some plate in front of his Harikatha. Gokisa Babaji Maharaj speaking, he is so cheater. He is saying Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Chaitanya, putting one pranami plate. Pranami plate. Pranami plate, so that people can pranami. Don't give any teachings to him, Siddhanta. It's so heavily. Amar Prabhu, he is approaching you sometime to get something, Siddhanta. Don't speak, because he is chitta. At present, he is putting pranami plate in front of Harikatha. He want to get some pranami and pratishta. Prabhasana, okay, Babaji Maharaj. As you speak, I can. So only Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj, heavy. One day, you know, I already told that I have no time because, you know, like Siddhanta Sagar is the ocean of Siddhanta. Which angle I can touch, which angle I cannot touch, I get puzzled. So regarding Diksha, Prabhupada, you know everything. 18 times he was cheated by Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj. Now last time saying, oh, you are the worshipper, you are doing bhajan of that absolute teacher. Cheater, that Krishna. So naturally you are also going to cheat me. Okay, you need not give Diksha. I am going to jump into Ganga. Running, running, running. I can jump and leave, give my life to Ganga. Go, yeah. Prabhu, Prabhu, Amar Prabhu, come, come, come. I can give the Harinam to you. Come, come. Then that day, Prabhupada speaking, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I could realize the heart of this Paramahansa. One day I went to visit Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Paramahansa. That time, Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj like mad, coming, running and coming to me and giving some stone and one, you know, mud pot, everything to me. And speaking one, you know, half, you know, coconut, a broken half, two shell, you know, giving to me and speaking to me, my Prabhu, I give this to you. Prabhu speaking, what he is giving to me? One half shell of that coconut, some stone piece, some dust particle, and something. Prabhu looking at the lotus feet of Gurudev. What kind of Paramahansa he is? Prabhu speaking. And 18th time, when Prabhupada going again, you told me to come. Then Gaur Kishor Babaji speaking, I wanted to take permission from Gaur Hari. Gaur is speaking that material pratishtha, high caste and high education, you know, those who are learned, pandit, They have no value and to a lotus feet of Gaura, Gauranga Mahapu. I couldn't. Oh, really? I wanted to take permission from Gauranga, but Gauranga speaking, here in my, in front of me, there's no value of any material education, whatever high education he can have, and how much money and position. Prabhu speaking, when I first approached my Guru Pad Padma to take darshan of that Paramahansa Guru, when I reached, I was shocked to see the lotus, you know, feet of Guru Pad Padma. From the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, the nail, one light beam coming to my eyes and make me blind to see material thing. I could see the clearly the true lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma. Then that day, I could realize my Gurudev wanted to provide a big fist kick on me, to throw me, wanted to prove what kind of education material panditya I have, what kind of high position I have in my society, all as a zero value. That day I could realize after watching the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma. That is called Guru Darshan. We are so foolish and idiot. We are going to take darshan of Vaishnava and Guru. I want to calculate how much position he has up to now. Wow, thousands of people taking shelter of that Guru. No, useless, that means. No position, rank. This is our Guru Darshan. We are kapat. This is our Guru Darshan. We are kapat. So, we are ever blind. We cannot see Guru Pad Padma. Prabhupada want to see those who coming to me with some other desire, annavilas, they want to cheat me, I also want to cheat them. How power they have to cheat me, I like to see. Life after life, I like to cheat them because they wanted to cheat me. They never wanted to get actual thing from me. They never wanted to get that absolute truth from me. They came in front of me to get some patishtha, some money, position. This they wanted, expected from me. So let me see how long, how far they can cheat me. This way Prabhupada speaking. After that, you know, Prabhupada going here and there, whole life giving life. Not only Prabhupada speaking, whom you can accept as guru in your life. Whom you can accept as guru in your life? Who? You are playing your brain to understand who is guru. Who is Vaishnava? You are so foolish. But you cannot understand. Prabhupada speaking, actually, whom you can accept as guru? All the 24 hours who is busy with seva. This symptom. This is the only symptom. Not his passing lecture. I am not university lecturer, so you can expect a nice piece of lecture from me. I am not linguist. You can find nice language from me. What you can expect from me? Sasmin bhavancha kesave. Sasmin bhavancha kesave. What kind of direct feeling I have already received from my Guru Maharaj. That is the main important thing. What money you have, what education you have, what kind of popularity you have, we are less interested about that. We are interested about one thing. Sasmin bhavancha kesa, what kind of direct feeling you got from your Gurudev. We want to, through your bhajan, how much realization you have. We like to hear some firing katha. It can touch our heart and burn all anartha. Can touch Harikatha like flame and burn all anatha. This way I like to hear. We are not like to hear any philosophy. We have no time to hear any lecture. We have no time. That's why Prabhupada speaking, he who is always all the 24 hours, he who is always all the 24 hours, busy to do something from Hari, Guru, Vaishnav, Dham, Nam, for Bhagavan, like to do something. You cannot detect one even single fraction of second in the life of Prabhupada that Prabhupada is going to take rest. When Vaishnava, I have seen the life of Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami, night time, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, we understand that he is sleeping, but his tongue dancing. He is sleeping in old age, tongue dancing, doing seva. What to speak about sleeping? When he was a total coma, he is being moved to one nursing home, big, where? Bellevue. That time, he is playing, you know, doing Harinama, playing music, kirtan. Those nurse and doctors speaking, what he is doing? But he is doing mala. Mala? Mala is not there in his hand. But he is habituated. He is lying faint, totally unconscious, externally. But whose consciousness is totally there? Consciousness is totally there. Whole heart overpowered by Krishna and Chaitanya. How you can say that he is unconscious? No. Consciousness is there, full consciousness. And he is doing Harinam. No, mala is not there, he is doing Harinam. Speaking this. When nurse going to give injection, nurse sister going to give injection, this way doing. Nurse say, what he is doing? But one nice devotee speaking, he is, speaking grief. Whole life, no Mataji touching me. Now some Mataji giving me injection, touching me. You see the behavior. You have to follow this kind of. If before my death, I can find only 5 devotees all over the world, I am more than sufficient. Even one if I can get. I cannot expect that thousands of people can hear and digest Harikatha, give me garland and dollar. Foolish. I cannot expect this kind of thing. Who can digest? Not possible. Guru Pad Padma speaking, this kind of etiquette, Vaishnava etiquette, you try to learn. Remember, you will have to speak it to others. But Guru Pad Padma saying, I was brahmachari. One day I find one shouting, Popa shouting, nobody there, nobody there, nobody there. Why? Is Popa speaking this way? Popa in library. Library. Popa say, Guru Padma say, I was running to see why Popa speaking this. When I enter library, I find elder sister of Bimalapasar Saraswati, Prabhupada. Elder sister. By that time, Prabhupada, it was Prabhupada, because in 1918, Prabhupada took sannyas. Gurupad Padma fully came in the year of 1922. He was in touch with Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada right from the childhood. Anyway, some poor condition of family, he was bound to run with his service in government service. I can speak when Guru Maharaj, poor trust, service. That's why he took some time to come, because he was totally dedicated right from the beginning. Anyway, that time, Guru Padma running into library and watch. A fun elder sister. Elder sister mean? It's like mother. Elder sister mean, elder sister mean mother, like mother. She is aged. 55, 60 age. Prabhupada shouting, nobody there, nobody there, nobody there. Guru Padma enter, see, oh, so much careful, Prabhupada. So that nobody can misunderstand Prabhupada. Oh, I was shocked to see Prabhupada shouting. He's like mother. Oh, so careful Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So careful Prabhupada. In Vyasasana, touching Tulsi Deva, I'm speaking. If you like to get exact teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you will have to come in front of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I touch Tulsi and speak. Otherwise, I can die. If you want to get exact teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you will have to come in front of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. I promise. I say, you have to come in front of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And those Guru Bhargava, like Kesava Guruma. Otherwise, you cannot get exact teaching. Total teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, total. Total teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, totally we can find and reflected in the life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. More accurately we can say, in the life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, maybe you can misunderstand Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Follow? Maybe you can book it, but you have no scope to misunderstand Prabhupada. Still they are misunderstood. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in the old days, they forcefully take him to Rambagan, Ambagan, you know, in Maniktala. You can pass criticism, oh, why Bhaktivinoda Thakur going there in Ambagan, previous home, he is now Paramahansa. Idiot. Idiot. Prabhupada not going to Ambagan. Anywhere Bhaktivinoda Thakur you are taking Bhakti forcefully. Prabhupada was not there, then some of his sons came, I don't like to speak their name, they forcefully take Prabhupada and go to. You are sick, you must go. No, no, leave me here, I like. No, you are sick, you will have to go. Gone there. Some foolish devotee, they are passing remark, hey, how Thakur going back there? No, not Ambagan. He's going to Golok. Wherever Bhaktivinoda Thakur is staying, 100% is Golok, Vrindavan. The mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if you see, you can understand 100% he is in Golok, not in Ambagan, not in Calcutta, not in nothing. Nothing. You are speaking all lie. Prabhupada never wanted to speak that way, but Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. Idiot number one. Never speak in whole life. You cannot show one single instant when Prabhupada speaking that he is my father. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur never speaking, he is my son. Never. On the contrary, I can show you. I can show you directly, Prabhupada speaking. Whenever I see the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I can find Radharani is there. I can find Radharani there sitting. I can find Radharani inside him. Oh my God, this is the teachings. So the teachings of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur you must follow if you want to become an exact Gaudiya, a member of Gaudiya Math. Otherwise, don't believe others, those who are going to cheat you. Don't believe others. Spiritual mafias, they want to put you in trouble. So this way you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was taken there. But somehow Prabhupada take Bhaktivinoda Thakur here also. Last moment when Bhaktivinoda Thakur going on, Prabhupada crying in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Prabhupada never speaking, you know, lie is always speaking like, you know, it's like that kind of direct feeling Prabhupada having. Prabhupada speaking, Thakur, oh my Thakur, Prabhupada crying. In this Ananda Sukhada Kunja, in this Ananda Sukhada Kunja, this place, where Bimala was coming and praying in front of, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, crying heavily and speaking, Thakur, Thakur, please bless me, please bless me. Don't try to go away right now. I am alone, you see, Prabhu is there, but you must stay with me. You must stay more. You must stay with us for some more times. Don't try to go away. Bhaktivinoda Thakur manifests in Sikh Lila. When Prabhupada crying and speaking, next day Bhaktivinoda Thakur become fresh. Very nice health. One day Bhaktivinoda Thakur bless Bimala Bhasa speaking, my Prabhu, Bimala Prabhu, you see, I give you main responsibility on you about the whole sampradaya. Each and every member of Gaudiya Math, they have one respective function to do. We have some duty, we are not doing that duty. Like Santo Goswami write me one letter. I was bound, I was not, you know, willing, but I was bound to stay in Suryakunda. That time Santo Goswami write me, giving me reminder about my duty, about whole sampradaya. That letter is there with me. In Bengali you can read. Maharaj giving forecast. You have to do this for sampradaya, you have to do. How possible? Maharaj, long ago, Maharaj saying, now I am sick, I am now in Keshiari Mott. When I receive your letter, now I am sitting in Keshiari Mott, Karakpur. I receive your letter, I can realize that you are going to do some, we like to do some seva. You are not going to expose some kapat bab. That much I realize. So I bless you so that you can grow your affinity and seva mood unto the Lord of the Gaur and Radha Govindu. Yes, later, in that letter. And you have this kind of, you know, responsibility in your life. Hari Maharaj, that came true. How possible? This way actually, Prabhupada actually wanted to teach us so many things through Siddhanta. All the time Prabhupada writings, all the time Prabhupada. Jivedaya Krishnanam Eimato Shar. You understand the meaning? Don't mean this? Still today you don't mean this? Simple? Jivedaya Krishnanam Eimato Shar. Jivedaya? What do you mean by Jivedaya? How you can show to Jivedaya? You will have to speak about their absolute truth. Otherwise you are not saying Jivedaya. Jivedaya Krishnanam. You have to do Krishnanam and Jivedaya. That is topmost thing. Then you can go, all power. Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, Prabhu, I give you the responsibility of Sampradaya. What Sampradaya? You will have to establish this Daiva Varnasram. You will have to, you know, install Daiva Varnasram again. Totally, it is devastated. Totally. You will have to do. Daiva Varnasam you will have to set up. And, you know, Parikram, you will have to do Navadip Dham Parikram. All those bonded souls, they are in painful situation. Any Jivatma, if you can give them actual scope. Why speak actual? In the name of Parikram, I cannot do business. I am arranging people to do Parikram, so you give me dollar from foreign country. This is one kind of business. Actual Parikram. When actual Parikram can be done, that we learn from Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj speaking. Your Gurudev going in Vrindavan Dham, one by we are running very slowly. Because he can show us Dham. Dham you cannot see. Like Jiva Goswami Pad, shown by Nityananda, Srinivasaja, and not. Nartama Thakur, Srinivas Acharya, this way. So this way you have to do Parikram. Parikram doesn't mean you can do. So, all Parikram you can do successfully, provided there is no material touch, totally. Some material touch, but by the Harikatha of the leading Acharya, can inculcate the Bhava inside you that you are in Dhamma. Bonded soul can grow some material, Baba. They are busy with green coconut and these, that. Oh, Maharaj, you are thirsty. You take. Why you can take? I'm not. Green coconut, what problem, Maharaj? A green coconut also problem. Why, what problem? One devotee asking. Green coconut, there should not be any contamination. Yes, contamination. Because the cutter, they are cutting, you are drinking. After that same man cutting, make it in two parts, you are taking malai from inside. Say the Uchista. Oh my God, we never thought that way. You are foolish. Uchista, I cannot take. I am going to take Uchista of Guru Varga. Tumi to Thakur, ami to Kuku. I can take Uchista, but not Uchista of common people. I am ready, waiting. So, Parikram, you will have to be very careful. How you can do Parikram? Acharya, if not powerful, cannot lead you perfectly. Only you can get some material benefit to stay in temple, prasad without money, that benefit. But if Acharya is not powerful, if Acharya is not going to lead like Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod, come on, 85 years age, he is going, running. Maharaj, we arrange one riska. No, I cannot take riska. You are sick. No, I cannot take riska. All the way with him. Krishna Babaji Maharaj, 70, 75 years age, with Midanga, whole from the morning, 5 o'clock, Parikram started. Doing Kirtan. Non-stop Kirtan. they are not feeling any tired mood. Why? Because their power coming from up. Your power coming from Glucon-D. Your power coming from Kaju, Kismis. Their power coming for up. This is the main difference. Follow? So, if big Acharya going to give you leading, like Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, you know, then your parikram, dham parikram, 100%. Of course, if you are inclined. Not inclined that how you can get benefit. But still, dham parikrama is so beneficial that anyhow you are going to get some benefit in your account. That's why Bhakti Pumat Puri is very interested. Oh, Prabhu, you can again start Dham Parikram under the guidance of Nityananda. And you will have to install Daiva Varnasam. You will have to speak all about the Siddhanta, this, that, right, exact Siddhanta to public. I give you responsibility. Someday when Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting inside room and Prabhupada writing books there, Bhajan Rahasya, preface, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada writing in just next room, in Sananda Sukhada. In Sananda Sukhada Kunjo, overlooking Saraswati Nadi. Follow. Upstairs. I have seen the picture. Prabhupada writing and looking at Saraswati River. Follow. One day, actually, there is a big problem. Balighai Sambalan. Brahmin and Vaishnav. Those Martha Brahman, they want to prove that Vaishnav, they are all low caste, low, they have no etiquette and nothing. All Ravis, they want to speak against Vaishnav. Smartha Raghunandan Acharya, you know, from Santipur, he is the leader. And another big Acharya there, I don't like to speak name. If I speak name, you can shock. Don't like to speak. They all make a big group, leading part, they are taking leading part and misguiding people. We all fight. Why Gauriya Math giving this, you know, Diksha and Harinam, whereas they are not Brahman? How possible when Narottamam Thakur wanted to give Diksha to whole world against whole society? Hey, you are not Brahman. Why you are giving Diksha? Only Varnanam, Varnanam, Brahman or Guru, it is written. Okay. But you are blind, you cannot see scriptural analysis. Narottama Thakur wanted to give argument, then after that, Srinivasaji and all other devotees, they started giving fire argument. All Pandit, they are flying. Here also see from. Big thousands of people, they accumulate, they get together there. A Mamad gathering there, in Baligai, in Midnapur. Big Sabha for 3 consecutive days. Madhusudan Saraswati Pad from Vrindavan and Vishwambharananda Dev Goswami from Samananda Parivar. Big Pandit. Prabhupada was bound to speak. In my whole life, I am running from Kanyakumarika to Himalaya. Prabhupada speaking, I can show you. In my whole life, I have not seen even a single, you know, devotee like Vishwambharananda Dev Goswami, who is so versed in Sata Sandarbha. Prabhupada passing this remark. I never see anywhere. Who is so versed in Sata Sandarbha, Sikh Sandarbha, from any place, anywhere, speak. That he was in Sabhapati, chairman. Madhusudan Vachaspati, he was there. And then Madhusudan, I forget. He was Maharaj. He was there, sannyasi. And in the Sabha, they all request Bimala Prasad, Prabhu, you will have to give judgment about who is, you know, going to deserve more honor, Brahman or Vaishnava. Brahman, we are going to give honor also. We are not going to insult. But why they are going to insult? Why? Then information came to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, calling Bimala Prasad. Now my health condition is this, so you will have to go there. How I can go, Prabhu? Hi, you are Thakur, you are... Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, bless him, touching his head. I bless you. You can come out successful. Go and speak about the absolute truth. What Siddhanta, what Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, what there in Bhagavatam, They are blind, you will have to go. When Sabha started, they all announced, we request Vimala Pasha Saraswati Pad to speak on these topics consecutively for whole Sabha there. Then Vimala Pasha Saraswati started speaking about who is Brahman, who is Vaishnava. Brahman was one article, big. Giving all argument one by one, whom you can respect much. We are not going to insult Brahman. From different shastra, we can give point out different documents. Varnanam Brahmana Guru, okay. But those Vaishnava, they are more than Brahman. They are more than Brahman. Brahmanism is there already there. Otherwise, how they become devotee? How they become Vaishnava? You are foolish, you cannot understand. In Vaishnava, Brahmanism already there. Viprat Dishara Guna Jutat Aravinda Nava Padar Vinda Mimukhat Sapacham Barishtam. Sapach is more than those Brahman. They are not going to believe in Vishnu. Follow? More than that. If Sapach in their life previously, now doing Hari Bhajan, doing Bhajan, then they are more than that Brahman. So, Banhi, try to remember this sloka. Brahmi, Banhi. Banhi mean Banhi. What do you mean by Banhi? Banhi mean? What do you mean by Banhi? Hare? What you are learning? Banhi mean fire. Agni, Banhi, Hutasan. Hare? Foolish. I can beat you. So, Banni Suryo, Banni Suryo, Brahmanebhyo, Banni Suryo, Brahmanebhyo, Tejyan Vaishnava Sada. It is written. Banni fire, don't try to put fire, hand in fire, you can burn up your body. Suryo, sunlight, scorchy sunlight, then Vaishak, Jaistha, oh my God, you can get lu. Don't, they're so powerful, the sun god. But it is written, Banni, Suryo, Brahmanebhyo. All Brahman, they are powerful. Don't try to joke with them. Oh, Maharaj, it is written, Banni, Suryo, Brahmanebhyo. Vaishnava Tejyan Sada. Vaishnava is more and more powerful than Tejyan, like fire. More than somehow you can get rescue from Brahman, somehow you can get rescue from, you know, sun, somehow you can get rescue from fire if you fly. Eh? There in Rajasthan, there's some place there, fully desert, miles after miles, hundreds of miles, desert only. Nothing. In some place you can find some oasis. You see oasis, you know? Oasis. Some place. There are people, they know technique. When they are going in sun, they can take, I know this technique from Bajavasi. You know, aniseed, you know, aniseed? Maori. Very sweet. You know, you apply it in your kitchen. Aniseed. You take chew and some piece of, you know, candy, misri, chew. And take water from mud pot, you know, drink. 2, 3, 4 liters. I responsible. I know myself practically. When I was in Govardhan, there in Dangati, I am drinking at least 10 liters, 7, 8 liters. But where water gone? I drink and vanish water. I drink and go. Because hot, 45 degree, 44 degree, all water vapor. But they teach me some technique, those Brajavasis. They say, Maharaj, you have to, those Rajasthan, they are not devotee. They take onion in their armpit, onion there. But we cannot take onion. They take onion and they are going sunlight. They take some, you know, matha, you know, yogurt after churning the residue. You don't know? Matha, Brajavasi giving. taking and go outside, no problem. But those Bhujavasis say for Vaishnava, what? One fruit is there. That is called alu bokra in Vrindavan available. Some sweet and some sour, both. The alu bokra, if you take two or three, in English I don't know what you are. Alu bokra is rare fruits. Even not in dictionary, I don't know. Alu bokra. If you take two or three before going to sunlight, eat and go, no problem. No problem or any lieu. So nice. So you can get some escape from sun god. You can get sense of way out from fire. You can get some way out from Brahman. But you cannot get way out from Vaishnava, those who are very powerful. So Prabhupada established this. When Prabhupada, for consecutively 3 days, wanted to prove that way, all Pandit, they were set up. They have no power to speak. After that, when Shava is over, thousands of people running to Prabhupada like wind to touch his lotus feet. Vishwamanananda Goswami and Madhusudan, you know, Maharaj, they understand it. They can all and jump on Prabhupada. Prabhupada can die. Oh, they stop them. Arrange one big water pot, you know, big water pot. Like in Bhandara, when 5,000 people taking 10,000, we arrange big pot, you know. That kind of one pot they arrange quickly and put water on them, fresh water. And put the lotus feet of Prabhupada on water. Prabhupada not, no, you have to put that. Then, you cannot touch Prabhupada, you can take water. It is written that within a short period, all water vanish, like camphor. All people, thousand ticket, drop the water. Their big, you know, leader of opponent party, by now he is going to change his mood. He is speaking, oh Prabhupada, we are very impressed to hear your argument. I mean, Siddhanta, now we have one request. There are thousands of people, they want to take shelter onto your lotus feet, provided you allow some tea and a betel nut. Prabhupada says, I don't want to make disciples. You have to approve this. Only they like to take some tea sometime, and sometime, you know, betel leaf. Prabhupada says, I don't like to get even one disciple. And now, they are calling, come, I can give you shelter here, I can give Harinam, I can give Dikha, red clothes, sannyas, what you need. Even I can send to foreign country also. Also by that time you can get some foreign lady also. Lucrative offer. Only you will have to give Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev. This thing you have to say. Very simple thing. Only you will have to speak this way. Nothing else. Oh, Maharaj, I can do this. Facility. We want to get facility from? Who is Prabhupada? Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining. You don't know who is Prabhupada. Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Long ago, when Prabhupada was too young, one day Bhaktivinoda Thakur request, there, where? In Puri, the birthplace of Prabhupada. I'm not speaking about, I'm speaking about Siddhanta. I'm bound to speak this way because that place, there happened this thing. Follow? Near Jagannath temple, Prabhupada's birthplace. I'm not speaking about his birth, you know. There one day, Annada Prasad, the elder, very, very elder brother of Prabhupada, even from previous mother, not this mother, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Singh, Bimala Prasad, you will have to sit in this room because your elder brother is very sick. So, you will have to sit in this room. Whole night you will have to speak Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Yes, you can chant? Yes, yes, I can do. You can speak loudly, huh? Annada Prasad, whole night hearing this, Bhaktivinoda speaking. You think he is a small boy, took birth in my family life. No. I know who is he. Who is Bimala Prasad? I know. Then after whole night reciting this name, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, In the morning time, all, you know, family members and outside people all run and coming because there was a sound. Annada Prasad going to leave his body. And not only that, everybody, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhagavatima, everybody running. What happens? He's going to leave body. But in the meantime, everybody present there watching that Ramanuja Tilak there, that permanent Tilak. At present, there is no Tilak. But at the time of leaving body, they all find all different Tilak. This Tilak is very powerful. Vaishnava Bloc using is called power, you know, Dada Sangha. Matajis they cannot do, Dada Sangha. So anyway, so everybody running, they watch at the time of leaving body, they watch, oh my God, Tilak. Oh. And Annada Sangha, Annada Prasad crying and speaking. In my previous life, I was one sadhu from Ramanuja Sampradaya, I was almost successful. But that time, I committed offerings unto the lotus feet of this Vimala Prasad. Previous life. Maybe he was in different form. So I was bound to come and take birth in the house of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Please, I want to beg for pardon from Vimala Prasad, small boy. If he is going to bless me, I can cut this bondage and cover. You don't understand who is Vimala Prasad, then you can dance and cry. We are so lucky we are from Gaudiya Math. Why you are crying? Why you are crying? You are going to get that kind of power. You are, you know, fighting with small issues. Foolish. My Param Gurudev Prabhupada, how big my heart. My Param Gurudev Prabhupada. Oh, my Gurudev, Bhakti Purigishya, my Gurudev, Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami, how proud I am to shout loudly, you know, to shout, to speak loudly, that my Param Gurudev, why you are crying all day and night? Eh? Why you are not getting power? Power is, you know, many foreign devotees at the time of Gurudev. Gurudev was by old age, maybe 96, 97, 98, 99, on those days, foreign devotees, they used to come. Especially of the devotees of Gaur Govinda Swami Maharaj, or Swami Maharaj disciple, they used to come. By that time, Siddhar Maharaj also gone, Madhav Maharaj also gone. Especially those foreign devotees used to come. They are paying dandavat to Guru Maharaj, putting some question. We don't allow them to come too near to Gurudev, because they're old age, Guru Maharaj there. And Guru Maharaj, they are putting question, I am speaking to Guru Maharaj, I am speaking to them this way. Some devotees used to come in front of me. Why actually we are not getting kripa? We are coming from foreign country for long distance, so much suffering, we are taking trouble to get good association, this, that, why we are not getting power? By the mercy of Gurudev and Prabhupada, I was bound to speak that way actually. Kripa always, the shower of kripa always falling on you. Really so? Yes. You are blind, you cannot see. The shower of kripa always, you know, falling on you. But we cannot, like rain. Our pot is so leakage, all kripa going out. Shal Dhamma kripa, Nama kripa, Guru Vaishnava kripa, and all. You know, this, you know, what? This Ganga Kipa, oh, Harikatha Kipa, Kirtan Kipa, all we are getting. But we are not getting any facility because you are foolish, number one. This way, if I go on speaking about Prabhupada Siddhanta, I cannot stop, maybe 5-10 hours, a whole life. Who can stop? But I am bound to stop, but there are so many seva there. Vanchakalpadarvasya kipasindibhavacha patitanang pavanebhyo vaishnabhyo namo namah kipaya hori kirtana murti dharam dharani varahara kagaura janam Janakadipavasalasnigdapadam Panamami sadapavupadupadam Panamami sadapavupadupadam Panamami sadapavupadupadam Vanchakalpaturvasikavasana Patitanam Pavanavishnu.